In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. Today we celebrate the feast of Saint Bartholomew. He is also known as Nathanael. And today we have our gospel reading from the Gospel of Saint John, chapter 1, verses 45 to 51. And the verse for our reflection is verse 46. And this is what it says. Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Now, what is the background to this conversation between Philip and Nathanael? We find that Philip has found the Messiah and he has come to call Nathanael to take him to Jesus. But as we can see from the response of Nathanael, Nathanael doesn't seem to be very much convinced. He is very skeptical about the fact that Philip has found the Messiah. But what is very amazing is, brothers and sisters, that as we read a little further, when we come to verse 49 of the same chapter, we find that Nathanael confesses, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel." So this is very strange for a man who was skeptical about the finding of the Messiah, so quickly to confess that Jesus is the Messiah. It's rather very strange. So what is it that made him confess the Lordship of Jesus Christ? So for this, brothers and sisters, we need to look at the prophecies that are made in the Old Testament. Now if you look at the earlier verses, what does Philip say? Philip says, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." So he's speaking about the prophecies made about the Messiah in the Old Testament. So what are the prophecies? So what was it that Moses had prophesied about Jesus? So this prophecy we find in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18 verses 18. And this is what it says. "I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among your own people. I will put my word in the mouth of the prophet." So this is the prophecy that Moses had made about the Messiah. And if you look at the Old Testament, we will find that there are many prophecies about the Messiah. And a few of these prophecies refer to the Messiah as the branch or the shoot. So if this is one prophecy from the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 11 verses 1 says, "A shoot shall come out from the stalk of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of its roots." Again, a similar prophecy we have in the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 33 verses 15 says, "In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land." So these are two prophecies that refer to the Messiah as being the branch or the shoot. Now if you look at the Hebrew language, the word for branch or shoot is netzer. And this word netzer is also the root word from which we have Nazareth. So Jesus, who is the Messiah, is the netzer. And Jesus, who is the Messiah, is also from Nazareth. He's from the town of Nazareth. Now if you look at the confession of Nathanael, Nathanael confesses that Jesus is the Son of God and the King of Israel. Now just before this, we have a conversation that takes place between Jesus and Nathanael. And Nathanael asks Jesus, "How do you know me?" And Jesus tells, "I saw you under the fig tree." Now what is the significance of the fig tree? So if we look at the book of Zechariah, there is a prophecy which involves the fig tree. It is in Zechariah chapter 3 verses 8 to 10. And this is what it says. "I am going to bring my servant the branch. On that day, says the Lord of hosts, you will invite each other to come under your vine and fig tree." So this prophecy says that in the day of the branch, that is in the day of the Messiah, in the day of the Netzer, what is going to happen? The Israelites are going to invite each other under the fig tree and under the vine, just as Jesus invited, as Jesus saw Nathanael under the fig tree, and later Philip invited him to come and see Jesus. So when Nathanael was having this conversation with Jesus, all these prophecies that Nathanael had read about and that he had studied in the scriptures suddenly came alive to him. And that is what led him to a conviction. And that conviction led him to make this confession that, Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel. So in the light of this reflection, brothers and sisters, let us look at our own lives. How well versed are we in the scriptures? Nathanael's awareness of the scriptures led him to a confession of the Lordship of Christ. Am I a person who is rooted in the Word? Because brothers and sisters, if we are people who are of the Word, then our faith has more conviction. We have more conviction in the person of Christ. Especially if we have a good knowledge of the Old Testament, the New Testament comes out very powerfully alive and active in our lives. So let us take time to look at our lives. Are we people of the Word? Are we people who make time for the Word? Is it part of our daily prayer life that we sit with the Word, we try to study and understand it? The second point of reflection, brothers and sisters, is Nathanael's prejudice. The response of Nathanael towards Philip was highly prejudiced. But the goodness in Nathanael is that he was willing to let go of this prejudice and accept the invitation of Philip. Come and see. What about us, brothers and sisters? We all have our prejudices. We all have our judgments. There are people we are highly prejudiced against. There are people against whom we don't like because we have formed our own opinion about them. Are we willing to let go? As Nathanael was ready to let go of his prejudice, go. Just imagine if he had not let, if he had rigidly held on to his prejudice, what a big loss it would have been to him. Similarly, brothers and sisters, how many wonderful relationships we are losing out because we are holding on to our prejudice, because we are not yielding to the Spirit, and because we are being judgmental. Every prejudice, every judgmental attitude of ours is a barrier that we build around ourselves that prevents us from accepting people, that prevents us from loving people the way they are. And the third point of reflection is come and see. Nathanael accepted the invitation of come and see, and he was a transformed person. Can I give this invitation of come and see to the people around me? Can I tell my friends, my neighbors, why the people in my own family, come and see the change or the transformation that the Lord has made in my life? Come and see how, in spite of my weaknesses and in spite of my struggles, I am, with the grace of God, trying to walk the narrow path. Come and see. Or are we afraid that if people come and see, our lives will be shown to be in a poorer light, that we are not the right witnesses for the Lord? So brothers and sisters, as we reflect on these three points of how Nathanael was rooted in the Word, of how he was willing to give up his prejudice, how he went and accepted the invitation of Philip, went and saw, and his life was transformed. And as we apply that to our own lives, let us ask the Lord to give us the grace that the reflections that we have had, the insights that we have received from this Word, we will be able to put at least some part of it into our practical use in our daily lives. Let us close our eyes for a moment. God, our loving Father, we praise you and glorify you, Lord, for this beautiful scripture verse that you have given for our reflection, Lord. We bless you, Lord, for the insights that you have given us, Lord. Lord, we pray that you will give us the grace, like Nathanael, to be rooted in the Word, Lord. That we will make time, Lord, to dig deep into your Word, Lord, and to find the truths, and these truths will transform our life, Lord. Lord, we also pray that you will give us the grace by the power of your Spirit to let go of our prejudices, Lord, to break down the barriers that we have built up, Lord, so that we are able to accept people, we are able to love people the way they are, Lord. And finally, Lord, we pray that we may be authentic Christians, Lord, that we may be people who walk the talk, Lord, that when others see us, Lord, they will know that, yes, these are different people, Lord, that these are people who belong to the kingdom of the light, Lord, and that we may be effective witnesses to you, Lord, so that we are able to draw other people to your kingdom, Lord, and so that your name is glorified. We make this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with each one of us.
subscribe to our channel. Give it a thumbs up if you like the video. Comment below in the comment section and also share it with others. Don't forget to click the bell icon for notifications. Thank you and God bless.